now we're given a zero. We're going to completely factor this. So 2 is a zero. When they tell you it's a zero, that's the same thing as saying x equals 2, which means that can go in the box. Making sure I have all the descending exponents. 3, 2, 1. All right. It should come out to be a zero because it told me it was a zero. Now, once that happens, that means I have a depressed polynomial. 6x squared plus x minus 1. And I'm going to factor that. So factoring my way. So multiplying first and last, I get negative 6. Factors of negative 6 that would add to 1, that would be 3x, positive 3x, and negative 2x. I'm factoring by grouping. So I'm going to group these and group these. These have a 3x in common, leaving me x plus 1. 2x plus 1, and these have a negative 1 in common, leaving me 2x plus 1. So my factors are, this factor should match, that is one of my factors, 2x plus 1. These two pieces, 3x minus 1, make the other factor, and then x equals 2 is also a factor. Move the 2 to the other side, and I get x minus 2. So this is the fully factored function. All right? Listing all the possible rational roots. So remember, that's our P and Q list. So I'm going to take 8, write all the factors of 8. Take my lead coefficient of 1 and write the factors of 1. So my possible list is positive and negative 1 over 1, positive and negative 2 over 1, positive and negative 4 over 1, positive and negative 8 over 1. And then we're going to synthetically divide and see if we can find our zeros. So 1, negative 2, negative 9, 2, and 8. I usually start with 1, and then if that doesn't work, I'll go to negative 1. And it does. That's so nice. But that just took me down from a quartic to the fourth degree to the third degree. So I need another zero. I'm going to assume it's not a double root and not use one again. So I'll try negative one this time with these new coefficients. And luckily for me, that worked. So that's x squared minus 2x minus 8. I didn't even look that up. I was tempted to just grab a calculator and check it, but I didn't even have to. This factors is x minus 4, x plus 2. That's two of the factors. And then these two zeros that I found are the other factors. So they would be x minus 1 and x plus 1. So that's the fully factored function for A. All right, so we have to do the same thing for B. Now, my list is going to be longer because my lead coefficient is 9. So my list of possible zeros is going to be a lot longer. All right, so first we have to factor 20. 1, 2, 4, 5, 10, and 20. And then factors of 9 are 1, 3, and 9. So this is going to be a pretty long list. Positive and negative 1 over 1, 1 over 3, 1 over 9. And they're always positive and negative. Positive and negative 2 over 1, 2 over 3, and 2 over 9. Positive and negative 4 over 1, 4 over 3, and 4 over 9. Positive and negative 5 over 1, 5 over 3, and 5 over 9. Positive and negative 10 over 1, 10 over 3, 10 over 9. Positive and negative 20 over 1, 20 over 3. That's a lot. I sure hope 1 or negative 1 is one of these. Okay, so let's see. Let's try 1 first. My coefficients are 9, 54, 41, and 20. Negative 45. So 1 doesn't work, so let's try negative 1. Okay, so negative 1 doesn't work. Divide some more. Let's try 2. That's not going to work. Let's try 5. That's on my list. That's right here. I just feel like if I do 9 times 5, at least that's 45. That might be closer. All right, so now that gets me, so it started out cubic, so now this is squared. So 9x squared minus 9x minus 4. Let's see if I multiply. It gives me negative 36. It's going to be split into negative 12x plus 3x minus 4. So I'm going to group this. And then the one I found was 5, so that'd be written as a factor of x minus 5. So that's all of the factors of b. Alright. Alright, so on 7 we're doing the reverse. This time they've given me the zeros and they want me to come up with the equation. So if they told